Ireland, once only known for its boiled potatoes, has recently gained respect as a culinary destination. At the forefront of this movement, deep in the Irish countryside, Ballymaloe Manor House and Cookery School is one of Ireland's hidden gems, quietly raising the bar for culinary excellence. My friend, TV chef and Ballymaloe cooking instructor Rachel Allen, shared her insight regarding Ireland's culinary revolution.
There's a huge amount of pride that the Irish have in our produce. I love seeing that, the resurgence of country markets and farmers markets.
Do you think there's a real understanding of Irish foods and cuisine in the States?
People think of Irish, I think a lot of people think of it as boiled bacon and cabbage. And overcooked bacon and cabbage.
Yes. This tea is just spectacular. Is this typical what you would find now in an Irish tea? Mm. The various scones and cakes.
In a very smart Irish base, but the scones would be always spread with good homemade jam, you know, raspberry jam or a strawberry jam.
And tea sandwiches, and I'm sure there's something here with brown bread. And
smoked salmon, of course.
Did you know in Ireland, I'm sure you do, you live here, that you can be anywhere in this whole island, in the whole nation, you're only 2 minutes away from brown bread.
Really? I love it.
We just pull over on the side of the road, we're looking at our maps, and people pull over.
2 minutes.
Would you like some brown bread and butter?
Of course. It's brown bread, butter, and smoked salmon.
In all your books, your entertaining books, I think you have an at-home book or...
Yes, Rachel's.
Rachel at Home.
Food
right?
at Home. Yeah, okay. That's just come out in the States, actually.
That's, yeah.
And Bake, another one of my books, is just about to come out.
So with all your writing, what's your favorite?
I do love making bread, I think, and I love baking. I think some sort of alchemy happens when you, you know, have flour
there is magic.
And
yeah.
eggs and water, or whatever it is in yeast, and there is magic there.
Indeed.
And have you had some of the great cheeses here?
Oh my gosh, to die for. We went to Manning's.
Yes.
It's worth a stop. People should land in maybe Shannon Airport.
Yeah.
And then they should go right to Manning's, get some supplies. What an experience.
If it weren't for people like him, Irish food would have been lost.
Has Myrtle Allen, who founded Ballymaloe, had an influence on you?
Yes. I mean, I absolutely would not be doing what I'm doing if I hadn't gone to Ballymaloe in the beginning. Again, going back to that simple but most fundamental ethos at Ballymaloe, which is just start off with something simple, really good, and then do not very much to it and you get something divine and delicious.
But you also have a family life.
Yes, I think they probably take it for granted that we're definitely a very foodie family. Ballymaloe is just a couple of miles from the sea and our house is between the sea and Ballymaloe. Our boys are 8 and 10 and they love going with my husband to catch a mackerel. And then they will come home and fillet it and eat the hugest amount
of it. So they experience the whole thing.
Yeah. Exactly, and I love that. You know, the key to getting children to eat is to get them involved from the beginning. Okay, it's not practical all the time. I'm not saying, you know, every day. I was like, come on, what are we? But really, as much as you can, and to think of it as a form of entertainment for them.
Right.
I love what I'm doing. I count myself so lucky to be able to have enough time at home that I can get my children out growing vegetables.
Right.
With balancing it, with being able to eat in different places around the world and teaching. I love it. If it carries on a bit like that, it's just great. I'm very happy.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. It's a pleasure.